on the 2K Sports Network, broadcasting live from County Stadium. Playing on their home turf, we have the Pagans. They'll be defending against the Federals. I'm Dan Stevens. I'll be calling the game, and as always, Peter O'Keefe will deliver the color. Okay, let's do a rundown of the all-pro talent in today's game.
Joe Montana and Jerry Rice lead the charge for the Federals. These two guys can read each other's minds. The great quarterback-receiver tandems down through history have had this kind of mental link, and these two are no different. But they're not the only team featuring superstars. With a QB and receiver pair such as these two guys, you can only hope to slow them down, but you can never stop them, especially with a supporting crew like the one they have.
All right, Peter, thanks. Now let's go down to the coin toss.
Hey, kid, I'll be gentle.
Gentlemen, please make your call.
We'll take heads.
It is tails.
We'll kick.
The Pagans have won the toss and select a kick.
Brown boots it downfield, and we're underway. Barney fields the opening kickoff at the 10. Jukes stopped at the 30.
And Barney made a mediocre kick a little more mediocre with a decent run back there.
Everybody ready? It's going to be split twins, strong fold sweep. All out here. Break.
First and 10. The Federal 30-yarder.
Down. Sit. Come on, McDavid. Let's go.
Collins is at the 45. Finally stopped at the 47. First down.
Nick Collins gains a lot on this play, but it wasn't all him. Watch. Yep, he owes everything to those blockers, baby. They cleared the path for him.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
First and 10.
Montana throws a header. The reception's made at the 36. Hammered down at the 34.
13 on the play. First down, Federals.
First down, both wideouts to the right. Collins has his number called on first down and barely picks up the first down.
That's what you get. Yeah, first down.
First and 10.
Picks up 6 on the play, and that will bring up second down.
6 yards on the play. Van Pelt credited with the tackle. Second and 4. Ball at the 18-yard line.
Simmons takes him down back at the 20.
All right, big play. Let's do it again.
Oh, yeah. I hope they come at us the same way.
Hey.
Third and six.
Bring up fourth down.
Oh, look, it's Gansy. Let him bear down your ass, huh?
Come on, they'll come in to attempt a field goal from the 23 yard line. Nothing will hold the kick.
Conway. Kicks from 40 yards out, and they take the lead.
Nate Conway kicks the field goal, but watch how close the ball gets to the upright. Man, a few more inches and he'd have made the highlight reel, not the way he would have wanted to, though.
Conway boots it away. Mitchell catches it back at the 8. Catches a tackle. Tackled at the 28.
Mitchell tried to run it out, but the defense preferred that he stayed put, and they made their case pretty forcefully there.
Gets the handoff and heads out right. Tackled at the 29.
Jason Canada got some help on that one in the form of blocking, but he still couldn't make a play out of it.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Short loss.
Troy Ulmer read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That will bring up a third and long. First on third and long.
Brady throws right past the coverage and into his receiver's hands. Nice throw.
Third and long, and they get the big play to convert. What do you think of that, Peter?
I love it. That's what football is all about, making the big plays when you need to, and you can't coach that.
First down, one man back. Brady rifles it up. It's complete at the 42, and he's stopped right there. Gets back to the line of scrimmage, but not quite before he's taken down.
Charlie Smith got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Brady throws a heater right sideline, and it's complete for a gain of 3 yards.
Brady demonstrated his arm strength back there with a solid cross-field pass.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Third down, 7 yards to go. On third and long.
Brady had only one spot where he could put the football, Dan, and that's right where it goes.
Now watch how he sneaks this ball past multiple defenders.
Yeah, it takes a considerable amount of poise and confidence to execute a play like this.
What a pass, and he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, absolutely, Dan. So far, he's got 51 yards and no interceptions.
Brady fires this one over the middle, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down. Up a couple.
Jason Canada used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second and goal.
Brady throws it to the left sideline, and it's caught for a touchdown.
Let's get more. Come on.
He beats his man cold. It's all about staking your turf.
Great effort to get him into the end zone, Peter.
Yeah, that's how to play the game, 110%.
Here's the point after, and it's good.
Feels mighty good to be in front, don't it, boys?
Brown kicks it away. Barney hauls it in at the 12. Breaks free, tackled at the 33.
And Barney took the pint-sized kick and ran it back for a gallon-sized return.
The Federals bring their offense on the field and will start the drive at their 33-yard line. Collin carries it for the sixth time and barely gets past the line of scrimmage for a negligible gain on the play.
Okay, people, gun, quad left, 50 red flood, break.
Third and nine from the Federal.
Down.
first on third and long.
Mike Simpson easily beats the double team to the spot and the football.
Perfect synchronization on that play.
Dan, you know, the receiver who can outfight two defenders for the football will make almost any quarterback look good.
Third and long, and they get the big play to convert. What do you think of that, Peter?
I love it. That's what football is all about, making the big plays when you need to, and you can't coach that.
First down from the shotgun. Casser. His first carry heads up field, finally stopped at the 35.
Nice gain on this baby. Look at him eat up the yardage here.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
First and 10.
Calls it in right side and gets past the markers for a first down.
You don't want it that bad. You don't want it.
And that'll do it for quarter number one. The Pagans are out in front, 7-3.
Tighten up that side of the line.
Collins gets the call again and finds wide right. Finally popped out of bounds at the 10.
Nolan Cromwell eventually gets there, but I don't know why he even bothered. Big gain, and they'll move the chains. Well, he eventually stops him, but way past the marker, this one's going to hurt.
That's his second tackle so far.
Three more.
First and 10.
Up a yard on the play, and that will bring up second down.
Nick Collins powered forward with the football thanks to some initial blocking. Problem was, they couldn't keep that push going for very long.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Collins carries it to the fourth. Runs into traffic. Van Pelt tackles him for a short loss.
Brad Van Pelt targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That right. Will bring up a third and long. Montana zips it to the left sideline and it's tipped. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Leland Nichols came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
The defense forces fourth down, and even if they had completed the pass,
it still would have been short.
Yes.
You have to run those routes farther in that situation.
From 26 yards out, and he knocks it through the uprights.
Conway could have seen his kick go almost anywhere because of this wind. But he compensated nicely, didn't have much trouble dividing the uprights for three.
They'll take the 3 points, but they were hoping for seven.
But that's the second time today they get close only to have to bring in the kicker.
Conway kicks it away. Mitchell fields the kickoff at the 11. Brought down at the 36.
Mitchell took a kick that wasn't so hot and burst through the defense for a big game.
This is the call. Ace 50, tight end, Y out. And break.
Going here after hauling this one in. Well, Danny shows great hands and a little wiggle at the end of the play. Tough guy to bring down.
It takes a lot of courage to make your living over the middle, I'll tell you, but we've seen him there several times today.
Yeah, that's a guy who's willing to sacrifice his body to make his quarterback look good. Jason Candidate used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Newton gets a piece of this one, but that's all incomplete.
Riddick Knutson gets to feel a little pigskin, but he's unable to make the catch.
Boy, I thought really he had that one locked up.
As did he. He doesn't look happy with himself either.
If complete, that would have made for a bit shorter third down play, but not much.
Not a lot of potential on that call.
Okay, people. Bunch 50, Z deep post. Break.
Third down and four wideouts in the game. One way downfield, and it's caught for a touchdown.
Mitchell is wondering if he slipped into the Twilight Zone or something, because the coverage is in another dimension. Sad recognition by the defense. Somebody has got to step up on that side of the ball.
This is a take no prisoners kind of guy when he is in the red zone.
Oh, after piling up some good yardage on the day, he makes a big play here for a score.
Sends it downfield. Barney catches it back at the 5. Back down at the 26.
And Barney got a very respectable return off that nice kickoff there, Dan.
The Federals came away with three last time out and are looking for more. They'll start this drive at their own 26-yard line. Goes right up the middle and gets just past the line, but not by much before being brought down.
Nick Collins didn't get very far on that last play, and he even had the help of some blocking. But I guess the defense had their number.
There on that last run. When you get the initial surge like that, good things happen, especially in the ground game.
A decent play, and they'll now face third and short.
That's the key, Dan. Make third down easy, and they did just that.
Now they just need to convert. We'll see what they do. Taken down well short of the markers. That will bring up fourth down.
Chris Ferrant read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
They take away any and all room and prevent that play from getting past the line of scrimmage. Fourth down coming up. Minardi gets the snap and punts it away. Lukens makes a fair catch at the 34. The Pagans got into the end zone last time they had it, and they're looking to do it again. They'll start at their 35-yard line. Bring up second down.
Rob Gesser read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Brady lets it go here, and he stopped right there.
Brady couldn't look the defenders off the ball on this one. Here's an example of one guy making a play against several. Oh, it was close, but his receiver made a positive play on it.
Nice pass, Peter, and he's really lighting up the stat sheet.
Oh, you got it. So far, he's got 153 yards and two touchdowns.
Second down.
Jason Canada used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Brady throws this on a rope, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Well, the winds are threatening to blow like a tornado, Dan. Bad conditions for the passing game.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down.
Third and eight.
Score.
Mitchell adds a bunch to that completion. Watch the replay.
There's the grab, and he just takes off.
He just loves to see those little white lines go by underneath his feet.
This guy has earned his team big points today. That's why he's such a key player.
Yeah, he knows how to make himself available in that part of the field, scoring his second touchdown of this contest.
Brown kicks it away. Barney fields the kickoff at the 6. Tackled at the 28.
And Barney was able to find some weak spots in the defense. Got a good run back off that kick.
The Federals must feel like they need to score this timeout. This drive will start at their own 28-yard line. Montana zings it to the right side, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Brad Van Pelt read that one right out of the receiver's break and denied it.
The defense stood up to that play and shuts down what would be a minimal gain anyway. It'll be second down.
Man, we need more out of you. Where you been today? Don't worry, man. I'm going to get it turned around.
Let's go.
7 and 10.
Sims stops that one cold way back there at the 23.
Tim Sims got to his man early and corkscrewed him to the turf for a big loss.
Huge defensive play, Peter. The end zone is getting farther and farther away for this offense.
Soon it will become nothing more than a legend among the team, and the younger players will scoff that it really doesn't exist.
Calm down. That's his second tackle so far. Montana throws the ball, and it's caught at the 32, and he's stopped right there. Blakely with the tackle. It'll be fourth down.
Steve Blakely chases his man down and gets him before the marker. It's worth another look. Yep, he let some yards get by, but he made the stop when he had to.
That will be his fourth tackle, and he's hitting hard out there in the secondary.
Well, he's making them think twice before going his direction.
Minardi lines up to punt after the 3-and-out. Takes the snap and punts it away. Lucan fields the punt at the 36. Tackled at the 40.
Ball will be placed around 40 yards.
The Pagans come out on offense and they are well ahead. They'll start this drive at their 40-yard line. Second down.
Nothing to sneeze at with that game, Dan. These guys are the complete rushing package, and they'll run it on you all day if you let them.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Touchdown, Pagans. Second down, two tight ends in the game.
Leroy Butler read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
Peter, he's been lighting up the defensive side of the ball today and getting some nice numbers out of it.
You bet. So far, he's got five tackles.
Brady fires this one over the middle and is caught at the 46. Eventually tackled at the 39. First down.
Hogan keeps the party going here after hauling this one in. Well, Danny shows great hands and a little wiggle at the end of the play. Tough guy to bring down.
He caught it short of the marker, but found a way to move the ball into first down territory.
That's a huge play on third down. Otherwise, they'd have to kick it.
It for the 12th time and heads left, tackled at the 35. Hubbard had to leave the field earlier in the game, and now we've gotten word on his condition. Peter?
The trainers have said that he's suffering from upper leg cramps. It looks like they're massaging it, but with time running low, it's unlikely that he'll be ready to return.
Thanks, Peter.
Okay, let's run. Ace 50, tight end, Y out. Let's do it! Break!
Brady zings it to the right side. The ball is caught at the 28th. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run. A well-designed play there, Peter, and they remove the chain.
Great execution. Receivers in there, Dan. They should flood that end zone with them.
Hauls him down in the backfield, and the clock will continue to run. Number 87 didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete. That would have gotten their first down, and he had room to run as well. Incomplete, however.
The replay booth will review the previous play. Whether the pass was caught in bounds.
Dan, when we check out the replay here, we should be able to see if the catch was made prior to going out of bounds.
After review, the play stands. The pass was incomplete. The catch was made out of bounds. Third down.
A heater and it's tipped. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth and goal.
Leroy Butler gets a hand on this one. Right there. That's how you play D.
That's the second time he slapped that ball out of there.
Excellent read and reaction skills make him a nightmare to try and get the ball past.
Here!
We're going to bust to the line and block this kick.
Four on the play clock. Brown with a 21-yarder, and he knocks it through the uprights.
Derek Brown has little trouble pooching this one through. Let's see it again. Yep, he knows that you aren't allowed to miss many of those in this league.
The field goal will extend their lead some here in the first half.
It's still early, but the momentum is definitely behind them now.
It away. Barney catches it back at the four. Stopped at the 25.
And Barney was able to find some weak spots in the defense. Got a good run back off that kick.
We're going with pair slots, 50 tight end out and in. Ready, break.
Van Pelt makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Brad Van Pelt came in and got a hand on that football. He left no chance for a reception there.
The defense stood up to that play and shuts down what would be a minimal gain anyway. It'll be second down. Montana rifles it out left side, and it's complete for a gain of 3 yards.
Listen up. We got bunch 50, Z deep post. And
third down, one man back. For the first half of this one, the Pagans in command of this one, 24-6.
Well, Dan, what do you say? You ready to dive into the 2K Sports Halftime Show?
I'll look at our first half numbers now, and the stat that leaps out at you, third down conversions. The Pagans are winning because of it. Let's see if they can keep up their dominance in the second half. Let's get started in this one early in the first quarter. After driving 47 yards on six plays, Conway comes on for the field goal try. Good spot, and this one is right through, no sweat. A 41-yard field goal. The Federals strike first and go up by three. Towards the end of the first quarter, the Pagans inside the red zone. Number 11 would work his way open and pull this one in. A 7-yard touchdown for the home team. Trying to answer back, the Federals back by four. Montana went up top on a third down play, and he was able to find his man. They climb back into the game, now down by one. The Pagans, later in the second, number 12, went to the air trying to convert on third down, and he found his man. A 36-yard touchdown for the home team. The Pagans out in front, 14-6. Number 12 went to work on third down, and he was able to find his man. A 45-yard touchdown for the home team. The Pagans now up by 15. Late into the second quarter, this time at the 27. Number 12 connected with his man on this one. That set up an easy 22-yard field goal. Coming up on the end of the half, the Federals losing by 18. Montana went to the air trying to convert on third down, and he found his man. And that's how we'll round this one out. The Pagans are up big at the half, 24-6.
Excellent job, Dan.
The Pagans will get the ball first here in the second half, and they are dominating this game. Currently, they are up large, 24-6. Let's go down to the field. Conway sends it away to begin the second half. Mitchell fields the second half kickoff at the 6. Brought down at the 33.
Mitchell got a very respectable return off that nice kickoff there, Dan.
Ready to get this thing going? Let's do it.
Let's get the call.
Neutral zone infraction, number 79, defense.
Harvey Martin was lined up on the ball and the ref called him on it. That's a neutral zone infraction.
The Pagans are really in command and have yet another shot to score. Their offense takes the field and starts this drive at their 38-yard line. Kennedy cruises out to the left side and picks up a couple.
He picks up 2 yards on the play. Barney credited with the tackle.
Okay, coach wants this one. A strong zone cutback. Got it? Good. Break.
Second and three from Will Pagan, 40 yards.
Down. Sit. Whiplin. Dangle back.
Candidate will get the carry on second down and picks up a couple.
Ken Norton Jr. brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
He's got 7 tackles so far.
This kind of pickup should be no problem for us.
Great.
Third and one from Will Pagan, 32 yards.
Change.
Jason Candidate played it smart back there by following his blockers, and that allowed him to make some good yards.
A nice play, and with only a short distance to the first, they put it together and make it happen.
Yeah, third and short always looks easy, but it's not, Dan. That's good execution.
First down, 2 wideouts on the field. Butler tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Leroy Butler anticipated the trajectory of that pass and stuck his hand in at the last moment. Great play.
Potential for some nice yards, but the defense plays it tough. That will bring up second down.
Let's go.
Second and 10. Ball at the 43 yards.
Down. Sit.
Brady zings it to the outside. It's complete at the 44. Chase down at the 41.
16 yards on the play.
Brady doesn't leave much room for error on this one. It's either a great pass and completion or an interception. Let's take a look. Well, that's a great catch and a great completion. You don't see many quarterbacks thrown into double coverage like that and succeed. Again, he uses the middle of the field to advance the football. And, Dan, why not?
Well, they found some seams, some crease right in the middle, and Now they feel they can take advantage of it at any time.
This one perfectly. Great pass, great catch, great play. Let's have another look. Bullseye, what a precise throw. They keep doing plays like this, and he could be in big trouble.
Well, I don't know if any defensive adjustments were made at halftime, Peter. I sure can't tell. This quarterback just knows how to make everyone play his game.
In his third great quarter, he's still forcing the D to play by reaction, Dan, which takes control right out of their hands.
Kennedy takes that. Heads out wide, tackled at the six.
Here we go, guys. Tight triple, strong G toss. Focus on this one. Break.
Second and goal.
Short loss.
Leroy Butler got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
Another tackle, and it seems like we're always calling his name. What a hitting machine in the secondary.
He's definitely carrying his weight back there.
Brady throws to the end zone, and it's caught. For the score. Brown kicks it off. Barney takes it at the 13. Dyson tackle stopped at the 32.
And Barney could have really done some damage off that less than stellar kick, but his run back is only so-so.
The Federals are fading fast and desperately need to score. Their offense will start this drive at their 32-yard line. Collins gets the call on first down and heads wide left, tackled at the 40.
Nick Collins stayed with his blockers on that last one, and it paid off big time. You know, Dan, it's always good to have a wingman or two.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Tim Sims got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
That's his third tackle of the game.
Third and two. And the Federal 30 yards.
Right catches the heater left sideline and they convert on third down.
Jerry Rice faced single coverage there and was able to get by it for the reception. That's how you draw it up.
Well, you know, this is just not working. He made a good play on the ball, but for what?
This team is always throwing short. Problem is, they're not picking up any significant yardage after the catch.
Exactly.
Tim Sims keeps his man from getting back to the line. Let's watch. Pow! Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Peter, they put an end to that play well in the backfield, and they had a real good read on that.
Yeah, it all starts with the guys up front, Dan, and then everybody follows.
Second down coming up. The incompletion.
Antoine Grady couldn't have read that play any better if it was tattooed on the inside of his helmet.
That was the fourth time they've swatted the ball out of the air, and the offense is looking frustrated.
The D is showing excellent fundamentals right here.
Let's go.
Montana lets it go down the right side, and it's complete at the 44, 20, 15, 5, and he's in for the touchdown.
Frank Hubbard is going to make the catch right there, but that's only the beginning. Look at him chew up the yardage.
Well, they get the score, Peter, but it doesn't seem to make much of a dent, does it?
Well, not really. If a touchdown counted for 60 instead of 6, well, it'd be a different story. But as it is, they are still down large.
And it's good.
The point is good.
Conway kicks it off. Mitchell fields the kickoff at the 8. Down at the 41.
Mitchell is able to find some weak spots in the defense. Got a good run back off that kick.
The Pagans offense takes the field, and they will start at their 31-yard line.
Harvey Martin read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Up third down.
He loses 4 yards.
Charlie Smith makes a nice stop in the backfield here, throwing his man into the turf behind the line. I guess the ball carrier's travel plans were canceled. Oh, he's not going anywhere. Pow, you're down. Nice tackle.
Another good stop by the defense, and that will be two losses in a row. First on third and long.
Moss, he easily beats the double team to the spot and the football.
Perfect synchronization on that play.
Dan, you know, the receiver who can outfight two defenders for the football will make almost any quarterback look good.
He has definitely made his presence downfield today. That's his third rabbit out of the hat.
Yep, and if you're in coverage, you simply cannot allow him to abuse you that way.
Brady throws this on a rope, and it's caught at the 47, and he's stopped right there. Up a couple.
Let's give him no chance for three here, all right?
Hey.
Brady rifles it out outside. Back down at the 49.
Y'all see that pick? Textbook, baby. Textbook.
Okay, people. Split twins, strong fold sweep. Focus on this one. Break.
The Federals are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at their 49-yard line.
Nick Collins led forward with the football thanks to some initial blocking. Problem was they couldn't keep that push going for very long.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second and nine. Ball at the 39-yard.
Down. Sit. Oh,
Collins gets the call again and will lose about a yard here.
William Perry would not be denied and dropped him for a huge loss. Big play.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That will bring up a third and long. James makes the catch on the right sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
23 on the play. First down, Federals.
Joe Montana uncorks a dynamite pass there with two defenders on the prowl.
Really incredible accuracy, but I'll tell you, that's got to sting if you're on the defense.
Righto, Dano. You know, they could have brought eight guys on that play. Wouldn't have made a difference.
What a pass, and he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, absolutely, Dan. So far, he's got 170 yards and no interceptions.
And that'll do it for the third quarter. The Pagans in command of this one, 31-13. About three. first down.
Jerry Rice is all by himself, and he'll take advantage of it. Easy catch.
This guy can really twist up the coverage in that short area.
That's right, Dan. Those quick routes have been open for him all day. Obviously, that's what the defense wants to give him.
Great.
First and 10.
Montana throws a bullet, and it's caught at the 5, and he's stopped right there.
Second and 1.
Well, I bet we see the pass here, right to his go-to receiver. Dexter Manley read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
They managed to hold them behind the line of scrimmage, but they have another shot at it coming up.
Third and short. Let's see if they can come up with another big stand.
Hopes this to the end zone, and it's off. Incomplete.
Todd Christensen does everything he can here to find an opening for the quarterback to throw into, but no dice. That looked like it could have been completed.
Peter, in third down situations, they have not been successful at all with the pass. This play was more proof.
Boy, third is such a crucial down, Dan. And when you don't convert, it really hurts.
Fourth down, and they're going for it. The Federals want to talk it over, and they take their first timeout. Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Conway with a 22-yarder, and it's good.
Nate Conway has little trouble pooching this one through. Let's see it again. Yep, he knows that you aren't allowed to miss many of those in this league.
Although they get the field goal, that's the third time they've had to settle for 3 points from the red zone. Can't be happy with that.
Nope, you always want to punch it in when you're close in like that.
Conway sends it downfield. Mitchell fields it at the 14. Right down at the 32.
Mitchell could have really done some damage off that less than stellar kick, but his run back is only so-so.
This is the big one right here, boys. Bunch 50, C deep post. Got it? Good. Break.
Number 11 catches the ball out left hand, tries to get free.
Brady found a hole. the defense. Let's look at this again, because this is what you need out of your passer. Oh, he sees the opportunity and drives the ball home.
Another terrific throw and completion. This team is piling up serious yardage and putting consistent pressure on the defense.
Consistency, 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 even into the fourth quarter. If they keep this up, Dan, they'll have this game locked down.
Sounded almost Shakespearean. Almost. Martin brings him down behind the line at the 40.
Harvey Martin keeps his man from getting back to the line. Let's watch. Pow! Oh, that's gotta hurt.
That's his third tackle of the game.
Second and 13.
Number 87 catches the hard throw and is well past the markers for a first down.
Yeah, baby, yeah. Yeah, that'll do, baby. Yeah.
Woo!
First and 10.
Up 9 yards, and that brings up second down.
Jason Canada played it smart back there by following his blockers, and that allowed him to make some good yards.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Second down and barely picks up the first down.
We gotta start putting up a better fight. Let's toughen up.
Brady throws a heater right sideline, and he's on target for a gain of 5.
Brady demonstrated his arm strength back there with a solid cross-field pass.
He's been on point with the short pass so far, Dan. That pattern's worked so well, we're probably going to see it over and over again.
Well, why not, Peter? His receivers are open and making grabs, and nobody has really stopped him from doing it. First down and a whole lot more.
Hogan has a guy shadowing him, but still manages to make the catch. He beats his man cold. It's all about staking your turf.
He hasn't lost anything here, even into the fourth. That is a well-conditioned athlete.
He definitely put the crunch on the D with solid numbers in every quarter. What a one-man wrecking crew.
Oh, look at the quarterback and the star tight end there. You got to think they'll try to hook up.
This is a nice run, Dan. Gets all the yards he needs.
Not a huge quantity of yardage, but definitely some quality yardage, Peter.
Absolutely. Great play.
Peter, that will put a touchdown in his stat column.
And that's always nice to have, Dan. So far, he's got 28 yards and one touchdown.
Extra point, and it's good. punts it away. Barney fields it way back at the 9. The 31.
And Barney received that nice kick and a nice little run back after the catch. Good job.
The Federals take the field, and their running game hasn't generated much other than a big play here or there. We'll see how they fare as we start at their 31-yard line. Blakely makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Steve Blakely couldn't have read that play any better if it was tattooed on the inside of his helmet.
Yet another big play by this defense. That was their fifth batted ball today.
Yeah, you can see them start to anticipate the path of the throw the minute the quarterback winds up. Collins dropped the ball so fast there, you'd think it bit him on the thumb or something.
That's a good example of how he's not yet reached his full potential.
First drop pass of the game for him, and his quarterback hopes it's his last.
Third and 10.
Keep your eyes open over there.
31 yards.
Christensen makes the nice catch, and he's well short of the marker. That will bring up fourth down.
Leland Nichols made the save, dropping the ball carrier before he could get to the markers.
That's his second tackle so far. Lukens fields the punt at the 31. Tackled at the 34.
Amon Lukens didn't get very far running that ball back, but on the bright side, the kick was pretty lackluster, so his offense gets pretty good field position anyway.
The Pagans got into the end zone last time they had it, and they're looking to do it again. They'll start at their 34-yard line. Guard and gains about 3 yards.
With the carry, a pickup of 3 on the play. Smith with the tackle.
Okay, people, eye jokers, weak toss. Ready, break.
Second and 6 from York Pagans, 37 yards.
Up 9 yards, and that will bring up first down.
First down, Higgins.
Dan, this is why I love this game so much. Just look at all this stuff going on down there. Great moves, big hits, shrewd coaching, everything's going on. These are the kind of plays that make football the greatest game in the world, hands down.
First down, and they line up with 3 tight ends. Kennedy barrels up his guard and maybe picks up 1 on the play.
Jason Candidate powered forward with the football thanks to some initial blocking. Problem was they couldn't keep that push going for very long.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Break.
Second and 9. Ball at the 47-yard line.
Down. 6.
Kennedy gets the toss and runs into traffic. Barney brings him down behind the line at the 43.
Lem Barney keeps his man from getting back to the line. Let's watch. Pow! Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Another tackle, and he's starting to fill up the stat book.
He is dominating, Dan. So far, he's got 7 tackles.
Third down, 3 wideouts in the game. Second.
Charlie Smith made the save, dropping the ball carrier before he could get to the markers.
They stopped them cold. Fourth coming up.
Exactly what this defense needed to do.
How about blocking this thing? Come on, let's swarm this guy.
Great.
Minardi takes the snap and punts it away. Barney hauls it in at the 17. Tackled at the 20.
Lem Barney didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Federals will start this drive deep in their own territory with the clock at 1:49. Ball over the middle, and the clock continues to wind down. Montana zings it to the right side, and the reception's made at the 37. First down with the tight end right. First, the clock continues to tick down. Montana throws this second made at the 37. First down, 10 yards to go. Christensen makes the catch to the left and is at the 30. Chased down at the 18. It will be first down. First down, the clock is now at 43. Montana throws a beauty to the right side and they can't connect. Incomplete.
Damon James just flailed there. Horrible lapse in concentration.
He couldn't hook up for a connection there after completing the first 5 of this drive.
Yeah, he has had great success with the pass, no doubt about it, Dan.
Second and 10 from the Federal 18-yarder.
Down! Sit!
Cover your back, Dave!
Cover your back!
Go!
51!
Cover your
back! Go!
54!
The clock continues to wind down. The Federals take a timeout. That's their final one. Fourth down, and they're going for it. This one falls incomplete, and they will turn the ball over on downs.
Nolan Cromwell can't quite get position for the interception, but he does manage to swat it off course. Quick hand.
Well, they don't convert on fourth down, and that will be it for them.
Yeah, chalk this one up in the L column, Dan. It's all over.
Takes a knee, and that will do it. And that is going to do it for this one. The Pagans come out on top 38-16. With that, let's look back at some of the plays that made the difference in this one. So, the ball game is over. Let's take a quick look back at how it went with our post-game show. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. Number 12 is back to throw, and look at the finesse he puts on this one. A 33-yard play that set up a home team touchdown. The Pagans moving ahead big and now lead by 25. Answering right back, Hubbard came up with a big play as he was able to pull this one in. A 61-yard touchdown for the visitors. Towards the end of the third quarter, the Pagans leading by 18. Nichols shows some great awareness here as he gets himself into position to pick this one off. The Federals, end of the third quarter. Montana went to the air trying to convert on third down, and he found his man. That set up a short 23-yard field goal. The Federals back 31-16. Kennedy found a little opening, and that was all he needed. A 3-yard touchdown for the home team. The Pagans now up by 22. The Federals late in the fourth quarter. Montana connected with his man on this one. Unfortunately, they couldn't capitalize on the big play, and they turned the ball over on downs. And that's where we'll have to leave this one. The Pagans win big 38-16. Finally, let's give it up for our 2K Sports player of the game.
Number 12 left no doubt as to why he's one of the greats. Well, the quarterback gets credit when his team succeeds, and he deserves it. He led his team through the air with a big game passing. Just look at those yards. His performance made the difference in this one.
For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.